Hey, it's soon 1 year ago that the world bosses started to appear, and now soon comes the time for us to cash in on those legendary cloaks. So I thought I'd just make a quick movie to go through the different cloaks and give some short comments on what I think of them and what seems to be the intended use of each one of them. To start with, let's look at what we have available for the soldiers. And to start with the first one here, we have a high strength, okay constitution, okay-ish hit rating, high hate increase cloak. This seemed to be the best choice for Guardians, and also maybe for Conquerors, if we are going to compare it to something we have today. I would say the tier 4 tanking cloak, and we can see here we have higher strength, we now have constitution, which gives hit points, always good. We are losing a little bit on the hit rating, but gaining a lot on the hate increase. The loss in hit rating is not that big. We are also losing a little bit of damage by not having combat rating or crit damage. But for a Guardian, I think you still will come out on top because of the higher hate increase on this legendary cloak. So for Guardians especially, and maybe also for the Conquerors, this is a really good cloak. Next up we have the defensive cloak. We have high armor, high constitution, high hit rating, high critical damage, and we also have some protection. This one I'm a little bit more confused or wary about. We can compare it to, for example, Amara's Pride. Seems to be sort of a natural progression of the stats from the Amara's Cloak. Though it has less protection, that is my big deal or big problem with it. In a physical fight, you usually don't have the room to or that was wrong of me to say in a fight where you take a lot of physical damage, you usually don't have room to have such defensive stats. You need to be more aggressive. In a protection based fight, you probably want as high protection as you can, and that sort of makes the Amara's Pride a little bit better. Even if it has less constitution, you are going to mitigate more of that magic damage, so it makes it hard to recommend the Fallen Leviathan's cloak. But it's not a bad cloak, and especially if you are doing lower tier content, then for sure this is something that will make you very hard to kill, and it's not bad, but still not one I would recommend. Then we have I would say a Conqueror cloak. Guardians can use it, but really, why? It has very high combat rating, it has high hit rating, fatality rating is sort of useless, it has a high crit damage, and it has also offhand rating. Now, for the Conqueror, the offhand rating doesn't do that much. You already have a very, very high offhand chance on your Carnage spec, so Maybe you can do something with getting more damage if you are weapon switching. And you also have the tier 4 cloak, which is combat rating, the tier 4 physical DPS cloak, that is, which has a high combat rating. Not that useful, but if you are just playing Carnage and not tanking, then I guess it's okay-ish. For a Brute Conk, I would, or a mainly Brute Conk, don't take it as a first cloak. As the second, sure, but that's in another year again. Last, we have the DT cloak. Good amount of constitution, high magic damage, good amount of hit rating, a bit low but okay critical damage, and protection. This seems very strong for the DTs, and to have both the defensive stats with the constitution and the protection in addition to the high magic damage, especially when comparing this combining this with the tier 5 gear, which also gives unholy damage, I think this will be a good choice for the DTs out there. Now we are going over to the healer cloaks, and again we have a choice between 4 different here. Let's take one of them at a time. First up, we have the healing cloak, which to me seems to be almost too strong. It has a good amount of constitution for a healer item, 56. It has mana regen, which is almost always useful. It has a very high amount of heal rating. 425 is, I believe, the highest we have, except on the main pieces. So I was really surprised about that, and that is really what makes the cloak good. All the other stats are also very good, but that heal rating, pretty sick. It has good hit rating, okay amount of crit damage, and it has okay amount of protection. To me this seems like a really strong cape, and for especially pawns, maybe tosses, I think this should be the first cloak you choose. Next up is the Bear Shaman cloak, which is very good, it seems, for Bear Shamans. It has high strength, good amount of heal rating, it has good amount of combat rating, good hit rating, high crit damage, and really, what more can a bear ask for? It doesn't have much in the case of defensive stance, but when compared to the other healers, the Bear Shaman is really strong to begin with, so I would say that is not much needed. You can get cloak with some of the same, just weaker stats from Unchained Dungeons, but this is way easier to get and doesn't require any luck, so unless you already have that, you should probably go for this one on your Bear Shaman. Then it's a really defensive cloak. Very much like the soldier one that we looked at before. High armor, high constitution, high hit rating, high crit damage, and high protection. If you feel very squishy, it's probably situations where you can use it to great effect, but I don't see this being the most chosen because it doesn't have much in aggressive or healing stats. It's still good, and especially if you are doing lower tier stuff, sure, this may be an option, but for now, I would rather wait until next year before getting this cloak. The last one is the aggressive stats one. Good amount of constitution, okay wisdom, good amount of magic damage, hit rating, and good amount of crit damage. It seems pretty clear to me that this is intended as the DPS stats cloak. I have a hard time recommending taking this over the heal rating cloak, but that is probably mostly because my bias as a tank to healers that do a lot of healing. But if you want the most aggressive stats, this is clearly the one to choose. Then over to the next one. Now let's look at the rogue cloaks, and to me it seem pretty clear which ones are to be the best here. Let's talk about the two first at the same time. 100 dexterity and 274 combat rating. That is versus 529 combat rating on the second cloak. Seems quite close to each other. The Slayer cloak has a little bit less hit rating, no fatality rating, but while fatalities are fun, they aren't that useful. Slayers have heat decrease, and that is very useful in raiding situations. They both have crit damage about the same, and the Conversant cloak has offhand rating. So pretty much the choice here is, do you want heat decrease? Or do you want offhand rating? And for the assassin, for the ranger first, it's not really a competition. You can't use offhand for much useful stuff anyway, so Slayer's Cloak, it should be for you. For assassins, offhand rating is still not so good that I think I almost in all cases would take the hit decrease rating, even if the hit decrease had been worse and the offhand had been higher. There may be some special high offhand build out there that makes the Conversant cloak better for DPS purposes, but thinking of these two, for the assassin, I would say go for the Slayers. Then we have the defensive cloak that seem to be for all classes. Armor, constitution. I have a little bit of a problem seeing this being useful. It may be that there is a fight in the future where it becomes useful, but Funcom can't balance anything based on this, so I would say as a rogue you just scrap that at all. It doesn't have good enough offensive stats, and defensive stats on any of these classes are not that useful at all. Then there is a Barbarian cloak. Again, it's hard to say if this compares to the conversant cloak. The conversant cloak has offhand, and offhand is a little bit more useful for a dual-wielding barbarian. And fatality rating is not so useful, but I would have given this more of a chance since you still have the high hit rating, which can become useful since you then can skip on hit rating on other gear. But again, it becomes very close for the barbarian, conversant or terminators. The good thing about having strength is that it also gives defensive stats, so does dexterity, but the strength is better since it's mitigation and not evasion. So, lastly, over to the mages. With the mage cloaks, we have first up the DPS cloak for Demo and Necros. High intelligence, high hit rating, and high crit damage. Pretty clear cut, just aggressive stats. Probably the one I'm going to choose, but not too sure as it can be some more things to think about. And if we look at the next one, we have a high constitution for a mage cloak, high magic damage, good amount of hit rating, okay-ish crit damage, and protection. This gives good aggressive capabilities, but still also superb defensive capabilities. I see this also as a good contender, especially if you still don't have the top gear on your mage, then this can be a really good cloak to have, and especially if there comes some future content with high AOE damage that raid needs to survive. So both the two first ones, good options. Then we have the defensive cloak for mages. Again, I have problems seeing where it's useful, so just going to not recommend that. And then lastly, we have the Hox cloak. Magic damage, good hit rating, fatality rating, again, pretty not so useful. Crit damage is high, and good amount of combat rating. I would say this is the better choice for a Hox if you are going for an aggressive cloak. For Hoxes, it's still an option to go for the Infernal Mantle since that gives more survivability, but if you are going all out damage, then for sure Ash Mantle is the one you should take. So that was my thoughts on the cloaks that most of us will now get when next month comes. Thank you for watching.